I just completed my third time doing this procedure, and I'm going to do it a fourth time. So I'm going to put this glass on here, lock it down. But the legs are set up currently the same way I just had them for the third time through the procedure. So what I'm going to do, since I'm doing it again right now, we're going to kick the legs. I'm going to pick them up, move them. Now I got to reset, re-level, and re-measure up. And so I'll do that. Then we'll have a fourth time. I'll do the same thing down below. I'll kick the legs and reset up before I do this a fourth time. So I'm doing this procedure two times in one day. Since Friday the 11th. All right, I just reset the legs after kicking one of them out and re-leveled. My new height is now 5.055. Gonna go down to 401, kick the legs, and reset up there. I'm gonna kick these legs now. There, just took it out of that hole, moved it there. I'm gonna reset all of them. Okay, now I picked them all up, now I'm gonna reset and shoot some zenith angles. After kicking the legs and resetting, my height here is 4.985. 4985 at 401. Just got done down here for the second setup procedure through the day. And there's my data from this 401 to 402 for the second time today. Now we're gonna go up to 402 and measure back. I am at 402, getting ready to shoot back to 401. For repeatability, and my height is 5055. I've just finished my fourth time through this procedure, and here's my data. And here is the data. So this is from the fourth time, this is the fourth series through the procedure of measuring reciprocal zenith angles. Hey, that's kind of hard to say. So there it is. So again, here's my sets in both faces. And then what you do is you add it together. Does it come to 360? No. Well, this did a couple of times, right? So I had it exact three times. And a couple of the times I was over by a second. The mean is 52.8 seconds there. And then the standard deviation is plus or minus 0.9 seconds, and the mean plus or minus 0.4 seconds. That's pretty tight. And then the next time through, standard deviation a little higher, and so therefore the standard deviation, the mean is a little higher. And then this is what I came up with. So plus or minus 12.5 seconds of the deviation between the plumb lines. And that's lower than I'd had before. Right, so 20 was the one I had that was really high, and this one was a little bit lower. And this is from doing it the same day as series 3. And so I checked my work, and it comes out the same, thankfully. I've had to embarrass myself, show you guys my mistakes in my field book and all that stuff with my calculations. But hey, we double check, right? We double check. Nobody's perfect. Now, we're going to look at the 4-series average, right? The 4-series mean, and look at and analyze that. So, Rumford RZA series analysis. I think you folks are going to like this. So, series 1, 2, 3, and 4, here are the sums. The 17.1 from the 9th of October, the 20.3 from the 10th of October, the 15 and the 12.5 both from the 11th of October, one immediately following the other. So the overall mean of that is 16.2 seconds. So that's what I measured across all 4 series of 16.2 second divergence of the plumb lines, or also known as curvature. Now, the standard deviation of that mean is plus or minus 1.4 seconds. Now, remember, from the National Geodetic Survey, what was the predicted divergence of the plumb lines based on those two locations? It was 15.0 seconds. All right? And I was a little above that. I was 1.2 seconds above that. But what's the standard deviation of the mean? 1.4 seconds. That means that the right answer was contained within the error of this mean. That means I got it right. Okay? I nailed it. So I'm pretty excited about that. Now, why the variation in the different times for the series, different series? Well, let's look at the weather conditions. Let's see if we can discover some kind of correlation. On series one, the humidity was falling, not by much, but the humidity was dropping, temperature was slightly increasing, pressure was ever so slightly dropping, and it was sunny. I was in the bright sunlight. You can see that in that video. Links are below in the description. Second time through the series, humidity was increasing and temperature remained the same and the pressure remained the same. Should have had a straight arrow across there. And it was cloudy and it was also a little foggy, you can tell when I got there. When I look from 402, when I'm getting my rod height on the 402, looking down to 401, you can see kind of a cloud hanging over the road down there. And then on the third time for the series, which was the best time because it was exactly correct, the humidity dropped a lot, very rapidly during that procedure. Temperature increased a shade, you know, not much. Pressure decreased just a little bit, and it was cloudy. And then the last time for the series, humidity was starting to tick back up again. Temperature ticking up slowly still. And then the pressure was constant and it was still cloudy. So remember, three and four were done on the same day, back to back. And see if you can notice anything there. So the worst time for the procedure was series two, and that's when the worst humidity was experienced, right? That's probably the worst time to do it, when it's cloudy, a little low-hanging fog, low-hanging clouds. I wasn't looking through fog, at least not visibly. But there's a lot of moisture in the air is the point that I'm trying to raise to you. And it looks like dropping humidity, you know, getting into a moderate zone, dropping humidity, moderate temperatures, and an almost overcast sky, as long as you're in the shade. That seems to be the ideal conditions for land surveying. And actually, they are. It is the ideal conditions for land surveying. So it's kind of neat that this experience has borne that out through the data that I collected. Well, I hope you enjoyed that. There is no question that plumb lines are not parallel. You don't have to conclude yourself if that's curvature or not, but it is. It's very, very, very neat that we can measure that. And it's what FE Core should have done in the first place. They also should have done a proper level run. But this series wasn't about FE Core. It wasn't for FE Core. It wasn't for flat earthers. I wanted to see what's this going to look like on a 4 day, not 4 day, but 3 day procedure. Going through this as many times as I could in 3 days. I wanted to do it a fifth time on the last day, but I had other things I had to get done. So I thought that was a lot of fun. Hope you enjoyed it, and I'll see you later. Just got done down here for the second set. Oh, crap.